Hello there, grade 6 pupils. Welcome back again to another video lesson. So we are now on the second part of our discussion regarding multiplication of fractions in mixed fractions. So this time, I will be discussing on how to solve routine and non-routine problems involving multiplication of fractions in mixed fractions. So ganyan talaga sa mathematics. Dinidiscuss muna yung concept. And then, kailangan natin siyang i-apply using word problems para mas makita natin na hindi lang siya basta inaalam. Hindi lang siya basta pinag-aaralan kung paano mag-multiply ng fractions. And then, mas maganda kung na-apply din natin siya in real life situations. So for our lesson objective, at the end of this video lesson, you're expected to solve routine and non-routine problems involving multiplication of fractions and mixed fractions. So let's have the first problem. Manang Rosa is selling 40 bags of mixed vegetables. If each bag weighs 2¾ kg, how many kilograms of mixed vegetables does she have in all? Okay, so based dito sa ating problem is nagtitinda siya ng mixed vegetables. Okay, so meron tayong 40 bags there. And then kada bag daw, ang bigat niya is 2¾. So ang tinatanong natin dito, how many kilograms of mixed vegetables does she have in all? So yung 40 bags na yun, gaano kabigat yon kapag tinimbang. So here are the steps in solving word problem. First, of course, what is asked? So kailangan alam natin kung ano ang hinihingi ng problem, ano ang kailangan nating i-provide, ano ang kailangan nating sagutan or sagutin. So what is asked? So pwede nating ilagay dito yung question natin dito. How many kilograms of mixed vegetable does she have in all? Or pwede rin naman, the total weight of the mixed vegetables. Again, pwede rin nating isulat yung aking in-underline kanina. Next, what are given? Okay, so what are given? So ito po yung mga makakatulong kung paano natin isosolve yung problem. So una po na is yung 40 bags of mixed vegetables. And 2¾ kilograms weight of one bag. Pwede nating ilagay dito. One bag. Next, what operations will be used? Okay, so yung ating operation dito, as you can see, meron tayong 40 bags and then yung bigat ng kada bag is 2¾. So, since inaalam natin yung total weight ng mixed vegetables, so, ang gagamitin po natin dito is multiplication. So, kailangan ngayon nating i-multiply yung 40 bags dun sa 2¾ para alam natin yung total weight. So, let's have the next steps. So, what is the number sentence, solution, and complete answer? So, let's have first the number sentence. So, kunin natin yung 40 and then multiply natin sa 2¾ and that is equal to n. Next, doon na tayo sa solution. So, since ang mumultiply tayo ng whole numbers sa isang mixed fraction or mixed number, so yung mixed number po na 2¾, kailangan po natin i-convert into improper fractions. So, yung 2¾, kapag kinonvert natin siya into an improper fraction. So, magiging ganito siya. Yung whole number, mumultiply natin dun sa denominator na 4. So, 2 times 4, that is 8. And then, i-add natin yung numerator na 3. So, 8 plus 3, that is 11, and then over 4. So, ayan. Next, pwede na po tayong mag-multiply ngayon since yung 2 and 3 fourths is na-convert na natin into an improper fraction, which is 11 over 4. So, yung ating solution, so, 40 times 11 over 4 is equal to n. And then, yung 40 dito, lalagyan po natin siya ng denominator na 1. Okay, next. Kunin natin yung greatest common factor para maging lumiit yung ating mga factors. So, gagamit tayo ng cancellation method. So, yung 40 tsaka 4, pwede po natin yan i-cancel since ang GCF of 40 and 4 is 4. Okay, so pwede tayong gumamit ng continuous division or kung alam natin siya, we can solve it or determine it mentally. So, yung 40 divide natin sa 4, this will become 10. And then, tong 4, makakancel siya, magiging 1 na lang. Next, 10 over 1 times 11 over 1 equals n. So, 10 times 11, that is 110. Okay, so 110 over 1 times 1, that is 1. So, 110 over 1, 110 is our answer. So, n is equal to 110 kilograms. Okay, so, yung nakuha natin is 110 kilograms. So, paano natin isusulat yung ating complete answer? So, pwede natin isulat, Manang Rosa has a total of 110 kilograms of mixed vegetables. So, yan po yung ating complete answer. So, let's have the second problem. Mario bought 5 3/5 meters of string. He used 4/7 of it in making his school project. How many meters of string did he use? Okay, so, as you can see, si Mario bumili po siya ng 5 3/5 meters of string. And then, doon sa binili niyang 5 3/5 meters, ang ginamit lang po niya doon sa kanyang school project is 4/7 or 4/7. Ibig sabihin, hindi niya ginamit lahat. So, ang tinatanong natin dito, what part of the 5 3/5 meters ang ginamit po ni Mario sa kanyang school project? So, the first step, what is S? So, pwede nating isulat yung question natin sa bandang huli ng problem. So, how many meters of the string did Mario use for his school project? Next, what are given? So, 5 3/5 meters of string. And 4/7 of it was used. Next, what operations will be used? So, 4/7 of 5 3/5, we have there the word clue of. So, therefore, our operation is multiplication. So let's have the next steps. So what is the number sentence, solution, and complete answer? So just like we did on the previous problem, so ganun lang din po ang gagawin natin dito. First, we will write the number sentence. So 5 3/5 times 4/7 equals n. So since 5 3/5 is a mixed fraction, so we have to convert it into an improper fraction in order for us to multiply. So 5 3/5, this will become 28/5. So how come naging 28/5 po siya? So yung 5 na whole number, i-multiply po natin sa denominator ng proper fraction, which is 5. So 5 times 5, that is 25. And then plus 3, yung nasa numerator, that is 28. Kaya naging 28/5. Now, let's have the solution. So 28/5 times 4/7 is equal to n. Now, we'll use cancellation method. So, yung 28 at 7, pwede natin iyang i-cancel kasi yung GCF of 28 and 7 is 7. So, 28 divided by 7, this will become 4. 7 divided by 7, this is 1. Next, sulat natin yung mga natira. 4/5 times 4/1 equals n. So, since wala na po tayong maika-cancel pa, so we'll multiply numerator by numerator, denominator by denominator. So, 4 times 4 will have 16 over 5 times 1, 5. Now, our answer is an improper fraction since yung numerator natin is mas mataas sa ating denominator. So, we'll change the answer into a mixed fraction or mixed number. So, 16/5. So, how many 5s are there in 16? We have 3. And then, yung ating remainder is 1/5. And then, wag po natin kakalimutan yung ating label, yung unit. So, since we're talking about string, length yun, meters. So, our answer is 3 1/5 meters. So, ating complete answer, Mario used 3 1/5 meter of the string for his school project. Ayan. So, 3 1/5 lang po ang ginamit ni Mario dun sa 5 3/5 meters ng binili niya. So, let's have the next problem, number 3. Jenny has 6 1/4 liters of juice drink in the refrigerator. Her family consumed 3/10 or 3/10 of it for today's merienda. How many liters of juice drink was left? Okay, so it says there na si Jenny meron siyang 6 1/4 liters ng juice drink dun sa refrigerator. And then, 3/10 nung 6 1/4 na yun is ininom nila dahil nagmerienda sila. So, ang tanong natin dito, how many liters of juice drink was left? So, yung natira. So, let's have the first step, what is asked. So, how many liters of juice drink was left? So, ayan. Next, what are given? So, 6 1/4 liters of juice drink and 3/10 of it was consumed by genus family. Next, what operations will be used? So, since kailangan po nating malaman yung kung ilang liters ang nainom ng family ni Jenny, so kailangan po natin i-multiply yung 3/10 dun sa 6¼. So, we'll use multiplication. Next, since ang tinatanong niya dito, how many liters of drink was left? So, because of the word left, so we also need to use subtraction para alam natin ilan ang natira dun sa juice drink. Next, number 4 and 5, what is the number sentence, solution, and complete answer? So, paano natin ipapakita yung dalawang operation using the number sentence? So, una, yung kabuuan. So, 6¼. Tapos, ima-minus natin or isusubtract natin yung na-consumed ng family ni Jenny. What? That is 3/10 times yung kabuuan, which is 6¼ is equal to n. Next, so since yung isang factor dun sa minumultiply natin, yung 6¼ is a mixed fraction or mixed number, kailangan po natin yun i-convert. So, sulat lang natin for our solution. 6¼ minus 3/10 or 3/10 times yung 6¼, kailangan po natin yung i-change into an improper fraction. So, kagaya ng ginagawa natin, so yung mga whole numbers, multiply dun sa denominator and then i-add dun sa kung ano man ang number or value ng nasa numerator. So, in this case, 6¼, so 6 times 4, that is 24, plus 1, 25, over 4 equals n. Okay, so using the PEMDAS rule, so since meron tayong operation na nasa loob ng parenthesis, kailangan po muna po natin yung isolve. So, 6¼ minus, so kailangan natin ngayon pag-multiply yung 3/10 tsaka 25/4. So, itong solution natin sa product ng 3/10 and 25/4, dito po natin isulat. Okay, so dito ko muna siya ipapakita. So, 3/10 times 25/4. And then, 3 and 4, hindi natin pwede i-cancel. But yung 25 tsaka 10 pwede kasi ang GCF nila is 5. So, 25 divided by 5, this will become 5. And then, yung 10 divided by 5, this will become 2. And then, yung remaining factors, yun ang susulat natin dito sa ating parenthesis. So, 3/2 times 5/4. Equals n. Next, 6¼ minus, so pwede na po natin pag-multiply ngayon, 3 times 5, that is 15. And then, 2 times 4 will have 8 equals n. Okay, so ngayon naman, magsusubtract tayo. But before that, kailangan muna nating i-change yung 15/8 into a mixed fraction. So, 6¼ minus yung 15/8, i-convert natin sa mixed number. That is 1/7/8 equals n. Okay, so ngayon mag-subtract tayo vertically. So, 6¼ minus 1/7/8 So, since dissimilar fraction sila, kailangan po natin mag kuha ng LCD. So, yung LCD po ng 4 and 8 is 8. So, lista lang po natin yung multiples nila. So, write lang natin yung whole numbers, 6 and 1, and then 8. Next, 8 divided by 4, that is 2 times 1, 2, para makuha natin numerator. Next, so since pareho lang po dito sa midway natin, so yung LCD na 8, so sulat lang natin 7 over 8. Now, let us subtract. 2 minus 7, this is cannot be. So, kailangan nating manghiram ng whole number dito sa 6. Magre-regroup tayo, magiging 5 siya nun. And then, yung whole number na 8 over 8, i-add natin sa 2 over 8. That is 10 over 8. And then, rewrite lang po natin yung 1 and 7 over 8. Now, pwede na po tayong mag-subtract. So, n is equal to, dito muna tayo sa ating similar fractions. So, 10 minus 7, that is 3 over 8. And then, 5 minus 1, we have 4. So, our answer is 4 and 3 8. And then, yung label niya is liters. So, n is equal to 4 and 3 8 liters. So, ibig sabihin, yung natira dun sa 6 and 1 4 liters is 4 and 3 8 liters pa. Kasi, 3 over 10 or 3 tenths lang po nung kabuuan yung ininom nung family niya. So, 4 and 3 8 liters. So, for our problem number 4, so John has 8 and 1/3 kilograms of fork. He used 1/5 of the fork in cooking adobo and 7 over 15 for menudo. How many kilograms of pork did he use in cooking the two dishes? So, ayan, kitang-kita naman po sa ating problem. So, meron pong 8 and 1/3 kilograms ng pork si John. And then, 2 dishes yung kanyang niluto. So, as you can see, 1/5 and 7 over 15. So, ang tinatanong natin dito is, how many kilograms ng pork ang ginamit niya sa pagluto ng dalawang ulam na yon? So, let's have the steps in solving word problem. First, what is asked? So, yung what is asked natin dito is, how many kilograms of pork did John use in cooking the two dishes? Next, what are given? So, sulat natin is 8 and 1/3 kilograms. Tapos, 1/5 of it used in cooking adobo and 7 over 15 was used in cooking menudo. Next, what operations will be used? So, since kailangan nating malaman kung anong part ng 8 and 1/3 kilograms ang ginamit para lutuin yung dalawang ulam, of course, we'll have to use the operation multiplication. And then, dahil nga inaalam natin, how many kilograms of pork did he use in cooking the two dishes, kailangan din po natin yung addition. So, we'll have multiplication and addition. So, next step, let us have the number sentence, the solution, and complete answer. So, number sentence niya is 8 1/3 times the sum of 1/5 and 7/15 equals n. As you can see, pagkatapos ng 8 1/3, wala na tayong nilagay na multiplication symbol. Dahil yung parenthesis mismo is nagsisimbolize or stands for the multiplication operation. So, kapag nakita natin yan, yung number, kahit hindi man siya mixed fraction, hindi man siya fraction, basta katabi niya is parenthesis and then may operation sa loob ng parenthesis na yon, automatically, multiplication po yung operation. So, meron siyang kailangang i-multiply. So, dito, kailangan po nating i-add muna yung 1/5 and 7/15. So, yung LCD ng 5 and 15 is 15 mismo, kung lilistaman natin yan. So, 15 divided by 5 para makuha natin yung similar fractions. That is 3 times 1, 3. Next, 15 divided by 15, this is 1, times 7, we'll have 7 equals n. Next, 8 1/3 times yung sum. So, 3 plus 7, that is 10/15 equals n. Now, kailangan natin ngayon is pag-multiply. So, 8 1/3 times 10/15. So, yung 8 1/3, kailangan po natin yung i-change into an improper fraction. So, 8 times 3, that is 24, plus 1, 25. So, 8 1/3 is equal to 25/3 times 10/15 equals n. So, ngayon, ano ang GCF ng 25 and 15? That is 5. So, 25 divided by 5, this will become 5. And then, 15 divided by 5, this is 3. Next, 5/3 times 10/3. So, sulat lang po natin yung remaining factors. So, since wala na tayong makancel, multiply na lang po natin numerator by numerator, denominator by denominator. So, 5 times 10, we have 50. And then, 3 times 3, we have 9. So, 50/9 is an improper fraction. So, divide po natin yung 50 sa 9. So, makukuha po natin is 5/9. And then, yung remainder po natin is 5. And then, over 9. Nilagyan natin ng units, kilograms. So, our final answer is 5 5/9 kilogram or 5 5/9 kilograms. So, ibig sabihin, yung ginamit ni Jan sa pagluto ng dalawang dishes, yung adobo and menudo, is 5 5/9. So, I hope meron tayong napulot na aral dito sa ating video lesson. So, I hope nagkaroon kayo ng idea kung paano ina-apply yung multiplication of fractions sa word problems as well as yung paggamit ng iba pang operation aside from multiplication. So, kasi kapag routine problem ang pinag-uusapan natin, ang involved lang dyan usually is one operation. Just like yung first and second problem natin. And then, yung non-routine, pwede siyang gamitan ng iba't ibang strategies. And then, pwede rin po siyang gamitan ng two or more operations na na-present naman dun sa problem 3 and 4. Wherein gumamit tayo ng operation na subtraction sa problem number 3, then problem number 4 naman, addition. So, for the next video lesson, we'll have the next or the last operation, which is division of simple fractions and mixed fractions. So, ayan. Diyan naman, magkakaroon tayo ng review dun sa ating previous lesson nung grade 5. Kasi, na-discuss na rin or napag-aralan na rin naman yan dun sa grade 5, yung division of fractions. Kaya lang doon, simple fractions. Wala po tayong mixed fractions or mixed numbers. So, yun lang. I hope meron tayong natutunan dito sa ating video lesson. So, don't forget to like and subscribe. And then, i-share nyo na rin sa mga classmates nyo. And then, if you have questions, meron kayong hindi naintindihan, comment down below. And then, susubukan ko po yung sagutin. So, yun lang. Maraming salamat.